Hello everybody. Up till now we have seen the data types and the arrays, and in this video we are going to see about the structures. So in the data type there was the limitation that you can only store one element at a time. So suppose you are storing 5 and you have to choose a variable, then if you are choosing another element, then you need to choose another variable for that element. So that problem was overcome by the arrays, so you can store number of elements in the same arrays. But the problem was you have to take this all the elements from the same data type. Suppose you are choosing the integer data type, then you have to store all the elements which are integers. You cannot put float or character in this array. That's why we needed the structures. Now to make structures, I'm going to show you the syntax. So first of all, you need to make the structure and you have to give a name to that structure. So I'm giving the name as entry, and in this entry structure you need to specify that how much type of data types you want. Suppose I want 3 types of data types, that are name, which is character, and I'm going to make a string of a character. That's why I'm taking the array in this character. And the second is suppose I need an integer, which is a roll number of a student. And the third one, I'm gonna need a float, which will store the marks of the students. Suppose these 3 different types of data types I want. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna decide that what variable I'm going to take. Suppose struct entry, and suppose I'm taking the variable is e1. Now in this e1, first of all I need to mention the name, and after the name I need to mention the roll call, and then I need to mention the marks. So as I've made the array of character, I need to make a string right now. So to make a string, I'm gonna write everything in between these 2 columns. So first of all the name, so I suppose I'm giving the name as Amit, and then I need to give the roll call. So suppose his roll number is 1, and then his marks is suppose 6.5. okay, now the same I need to do for the another student. Suppose I'm making an entry for the another student, so the same I'm gonna do here, that first of all make a string. Suppose his name is Bablu, and his roll number is 2 and his marks 7. Now the same I have to do for the third person, so I am making a third variable over here, which is e3, and suppose his name is Chintu, his roll number is 3 and his marks is somewhat 8.5. now I need to print this data, so that's why I'm giving a printf command over here, and I'm making first of all name, I'm giving some tab, and then I'm making a roll number, again tab, then I'm giving marks, and now I'm making it to new line, and here I'm printing the data of everyone. So first of all I'm gonna write here %s, because I'm passing the string. Remember, it's not a character, even though I have used the character over there, it's a string because I have used the array of character. Then I'm going to make a integer, so for integer %d, then I'm going to give a tab, and then again %f for the float, and I'm gonna give the path. So first, which is stored, it is in e1.name. The second, which is stored, it is in e1.roll, and the third is in the e1.marks. This is how you can print those values in the console window. And the same you have to do for the E2 and E3. So just copy this and paste below and give here a new line command. I forgot that. Okay, now make E2 make it E3. Now let's save this and execute this. Let's see, is there any error? Okay, there is one. What is it? Okay, here I forgot to tell you that you need to give a termination over here. After that you made this structure, you need to give a termination over here. Now let's save this and execute it. Okay, it got run. You can see the data entry. Amit, whose roll number is 1 and whose marks is this. Bablu, whose roll number is 1. So you can see what we have done over here. We have just made a one variable and we have put all the information in that one variable only. And it got separated by itself by this structure entity. So how does it work? I'm gonna show you again. So we made first of all the structure. In structure we decided how much data types we wanted. So we wanted 3 types of different data types, and then we needed the variables. So I choose the one variable that is E1 and I put all this data into this variable. So as it was the character name of array, it was array, so that's why we need to pass the string over here. So I use the double colon which have gone to the name, and the second thing gone to the roll call, and the third thing gone to the marks. Same we did for the 2, and then we printed this name, role and marks, and then we printed their data just below this name, role and marks. So thank you guys, this is fun. You can also learn this and have fun with these structures. So please guys, like my video, share with your friends if they want to learn too, and please keep watching my videos and subscribe. Thank you so much.